So what is a granny flat? My name is Colin Frager from Council Approval Group. Today, I want to share with you some photographs of projects that we've done. I really want to expand your vision in terms of what's possible with the granny flat, because there's a few things here that you might love. Okay, so if I show you a photograph here, this is an example of a granny flat, which you might not have thought of before. So a granny flat here is part, in this case, part of an existing residence. So we've got the existing residence over here, which is the main part of the dwelling. It's a three bedroom. It goes down behind, also underneath the granny flat. But on here where the two open doors are, is a one bedroom granny flat. Now you'll notice that this is within an existing structure. So it's within a built form. It doesn't have to be existing, but it could be one that you build purposely like this one, or it could be a house that you've maybe you're building in the basement, or it's an extension, so it can be attached. So a granny flat does not necessarily need to be detached, doesn't need to be separate. Okay, another photograph here. This is another granny flat, which is in the backyard. And hopefully you like this one. I kind of like the architecture of this one. It was purposely designed. We got the council approval, allowed us to then tender out the project to a variety of builders instead of getting locked into just a granny flat provider that just does a certain number of designs. You're locked into them to do the whole project. This one, what it allows you to do is you get the approval, you control your own destiny, because once you've got the approval, guess what? You can go to as many builders as you want for a quote and get the right one that you want for your project. So whether it's a detached granny flat, an attached granny flat does need to be on the same title. It can't be separated. They can't have, it's not like a dual occupancy, which can be subdivided off. A granny flat needs to be on the same title. So it does have some disadvantages and is not necessarily my favorite investment type. If you want to examine this in more detail, please go to your ultimate guide in achieving council approval, which really goes through this in more detail and helps you to understand from a research point of view what you want to try to achieve. However, if you do have a property, you say, okay, I'm tired of sitting on the fence. I've done my research. I'm ready to go. Give us a call. What we'll do is we'll talk for 30 minutes. We'll go through your property, what challenges you're facing, and then work out a clear roadmap for you going forward. My name is Colin Frager from Council Approval Group. Thanks for watching, and I wish you every success with your granny flat.